Hello everybody, welcome to the channel Learn to Earn for Life.
Dear students, in this video I will discuss about the one line diagram, the impedance diagram and the reactance diagram of a power system. Let me start with one line diagram. A diagram showing the interconnection of various components of a symmetrical balanced three-phase power system by a standard symbols on a single phase basis is called as one line diagram. It is also called as a single line diagram. The purpose of drawing this single line diagram or one line diagram is to get the concise information, significant information about the system. Some of the most common symbols used in one line diagram are shown here. The line or cable or bus bar is represented like this. The circuit breaker is represented in this way. The rotating machine is represented by means like this. A two-winding transformer symbolically represented in this way. We can also represent it in this way or another way by means of these two circles crossed together. A three-winding transformer is symbolically can be shown like this, or you can use this way of representing the three-winding transformer. The current transformer is represented like this. The potential transformers symbolically represented in this way. A three-phase delta connection is represented in this way. A three-phase star connection with neutral ungrounded will be shown like this. A three-phase star connected solidly grounded neutral is like this. A three-phase star connection neutral grounded via a reactor will be symbolically shown like this. And finally, the three-phase star neutral grounded through a resistor is represented like this. The neutrals of a synchronous machines are generally grounded via resistors, inductance coils to reduce the current flow through the neutral during the fault. The coil is used is called as ground fault neutralizer, or also called as Peterson coil. This diagram, which is a one line diagram of a simple power system, it consisting of a solidly grounded neutral connected to a bus and through a step up transformer to a transmission line. Two motor loads are connected to a bus and through a transformer to the opposite end of the transmission line. The ratings of the machines, their reactances and few relevant data are shown here. So this is the one line diagram of a simple power system, and the ratings of each machine is shown here beside to the diagram. Generator is operating at 300 MVA, operating at 20 kilovolt voltage, and the reactance is equals to 1.2 ohm. T1 is equals to 350 MVA, 230 volt star, 30 kilovolt star / 20 kilovolt delta, and the reactance X is 15.2 ohm per phase. T2 is operating at 300 MVA, 230 kilovolt star / 13.2 kilovolt delta, and reactance is equals to 16 ohm per phase. Transmission line is of length 64 kilometers and its reactance is 0.5 ohm per kilometer. M1 is operating at 200 MVA power, 13.2 kilovolt, and reactance is 1.6 ohm. M2 is operating at 100 MVA, 13.2 kV, and reactance of 1.6 ohm. So this is how the one line diagram symbolically represented like this. This gives a precise information and a concise information of the power system. Let us go through the impedance diagram. Let us go through the impedance and reactance diagrams of a power system. The one-line diagram provides a concise information about the system. As I said earlier, the performance of the system load conditions or upon the occurrence of a short circuit cannot be directly calculated by using the one-line diagram. So there is a restriction for the one-line diagram during the short circuit, and the performance cannot be analyzed by means of one-line diagram. So it is necessary to obtain an equivalent circuit of the system for the purpose of analysis under the fault conditions or the short circuits or the open circuits of the power system. The impedance and reactance diagrams will enter in this picture. The impedance diagram is obtained by replacing each component of the power system by its single phase equivalent circuit. The synchronous machine is represented by means of an EMF source in series with appropriate impedance. The transmission line is replaced by its equivalent pi circuit. The transformer is replaced by its equivalent circuit, and the loads are replaced by their equivalent impedances. So this is how an impedance diagram can be drawn. A simplified diagram got after omitting all the resistances and the magnetizing circuit of the transformer and the capacitance of the transmission line in the impedance diagram is called as reactance diagram. So to draw the reactance diagram, we need to omit all the resistances, we need to remove the magnetizing circuit of the transformer, if any, we need to remove the capacitance of the transmission line, if any, then the remaining diagram will be called as the reactance diagram. The simplified representation of some of the important components of the power system in reactance diagram are, you can observe here, the synchronous generator is represented by means of a reactance diagram on a single phase equivalent circuit, an EMF source in series with the reactance. In the same way, we can also draw for the synchronous motor an EMF source in series with a reactance will be represented as the reactance diagram of the synchronous motor. Transformer or transmission lines are simply represented by a reactor with respect to the reference. Of course, the omission of the resistance introduces some of the error in the analysis, but the results may be almost satisfactory, you know, in cases, since the reactance of the system is much larger than its resistance. We can omit the resistances and we can do the analysis of the power system based on the reactance diagrams. Here, this is the one-line diagram shown, and followed by this one-line diagram, we can draw its impedance diagram, replacing each and every component by means of its equivalent impedance diagram. We can obtain this diagram. Finally, if we remove the resistors, if we remove the magnetizing circuits, and if we remove the capacitance of the transmission lines, we will obtain the reactance diagram of the system. It is emphasized here that only a balanced symmetrical three-phase system can be reduced to a single-phase system. In a balanced system, no current flows through the neutral, and hence the current through limiting impedances are not shown in the equivalent impedance and reactance diagrams here. The impedance and reactance diagrams are sometimes called as positive sequence diagram. It can be observed from the one line diagram that there are three voltage levels, 13.2 kV, 20 kV and 230 kV present in the system. You can just check the ratings of the power system components. There are two voltage levels, 20 kV, 230 kV and 13.2 kV in this power system diagram. There are three voltage levels in this one line diagram. The analysis would proceed by transforming all voltages and impedances to a selected voltage level, say that of the transmission line of 230 kilovolts. The voltages of generators and the motors are transformed in the ratio of transformation, and all the impedances by the square of the ratio of the transformation. So this is a very tedious procedure for large interconnected power system with several voltage levels. Hence, the per unit method is discussed in this topic, which would make the analysis quite convenient. Thank you for watching the video.